So hey guys, and welcome back to another video. And on today's video, we're actually out on the 2021 Suzuki Hayabusa. So we've got this for a few days, so we're going to test it, tell you what it's all about and what it's like for real road riding. So stick around, stay tuned, be right back. So welcome back folks, and as you can see, we're on the Hayabusa, the brand new one in the black and gold colors. I think it's gold anyway. And we've got this for a few days, so we're going to test it out, show you what it's like in the real world. So far, just the looks of the bike compared to the older Hayabusa hasn't changed too much, but I think the styling tweaks and changes they've made actually make it a better looking bike. So what we're going to do, we're going to head up the motorway, give it a motorway test, see what the wind blast is like. With this being one of the most aerodynamic motorcycles out there today, I think we'll be pleasantly surprised. But let's see. We're going to go up the M6, a couple of exits. Now I'm taking it easy on this bike to start with. It's only done 4 miles. It is super spanking new. Done 6 miles now actually. Done 4 miles when it got delivered to me this morning. So thank you Preston Motorcycles for bringing me this bike and leaving it with me. Much appreciated. If you're in the Northwest and you're looking to test ride one of these, or even a Kawasaki or some of the other brands that they've got in, head down to Preston Motorcycles or check them out on the website, and I'll put a link just in the top right hand corner just here. So this bike's full of gizmos. It's got cruise control, too many different settings to shake a stick at, but I'll go through those when I do the walk around video, tell you the specs on this bike. But so far, first impressions, couple of miles down the road, super smooth, great throttle connection. It already was a smooth motorcycle, but I just think they've improved it. Now, I believe it's slightly down on power and torque over the last generation, and that's all to do with the Euro 5. But it doesn't slow it down too much. So I've got it in setting C, which is power mode 3, so it's the slowest of the bunch. And I've got traction control on 10 just currently. As you can imagine, this is a brand new bike. It's done 6 miles and the tyres need scrubbing in. So while the tyres are the Bridgestone S22s, they're actually OE tyres made for this bike. They're not like the S22s that you would buy from a tyre dealer. So I'm not sure what they're like yet, but I will be putting them through the paces once I've put about 100 miles and scrubbed them in. So motorway speeds. We're doing about 4,200 RPM, and wind blast is very little, to be honest. This screen, if I sit back a little bit and just tuck in just here, I've got no wind blast whatsoever on my helmet, and I can just feel a touch on my elbows, but very little. So it really is a streamlined bike. It's always been one of those bikes to me that I class as the sport tourer or the hypersport tourer, where you could head to the south of France on this thing in no time. Or at least you used to be able to before all the speed cameras came around. One thing I do like is the clocks. They've not changed them from the analog. You've got your fuel gauge, you've got your tachometer, then you've got your center section, which is the digital section, which tells you all your information on your rider modes and all of that type of stuff. Then you've got your speedometer, and then your temperature gauge. One of the things I always loved about the Hayabusa was the cockpit area. Really, really nice. Now at speeds on the motorway, I've no buzzing through the bars or the foot pegs. The bars have had an adjustment where they've put some rubber dampeners on them. So let's come off here and head on to some B roads. Now I'm using the clutch, I don't know why, because it's got one of the smoothest quick shifters on any bike that I've tested recently. So yeah, you get all the bells and whistles. And it's about 16.5 grand. I'll give you the exact figures shortly when I pull up, just down here on the road. But for the equipment that you get on this bike, it really is a super machine and value for money. Brakes are really good. It's got the latest Stylema from Brembo. So we're just at Pine Lake at Carnforth. Some nice lodges next to the water. And we're going to pull up just at the end of here. And then we'll have a look around this thing and go through some specs. Okay, so the 2021 Suzuki Hayabusa. This one's in the black and gold. I expected this bike to be around 20k when I heard it being released. Basically, you're paying $16,499 for this bike. So I don't think it's overly expensive for all the equipment and what it's got.
The engine's a 1340cc and it's an inline four. You've got 190 PS or 187 bhp, and also the motor produces 150 newton meters of torque at 7000 rpm. The actual fuel tank is 20 liters and you'll get about 42 miles per the gallon, about 148 miles to a tank. Seat height, you've got 800 millimeters, and the weight of this bike is a whopping 264 kilograms, and that's wet, fully laden with fuel. Brakes on the bike, you've got the best in the business, the Stylema calipers, and these are on 320 millimeter discs. And then on the back, again, I think it's a Brembo caliper on 280 mil discs. Suspension, fully adjustable, KYB, upside down forks. And then on the rear, you have again KYB, fully adjustable, all tucked away, a monoshock just underneath there. Lights, you've got LED all the way around, that's the front of it. And then LED indicators built in. And then this is the new rear of the bike, which I think looks quite nice. So you've got the pillion hump on there. You can remove that and put a pillion seat. The wing mirrors on this bike, carbon effect on them just there. And also they do fold as well, so you can tuck them in if you're getting them in and out of a garage, or if you take the bike on track. The screen on the bike, as you can see, it's quite big. It's got a nice bubble in there that keeps you behind the screen and out of the wind. The actual frame, swing arm and everything, I believe is the same as the older version. It's just the fairings have had a tweak, and also the motor to make it Euro 5. It's got fully adjustable brake lever and fully adjustable clutch lever. Cruise control, you've got your mode buttons, your indicators, you've got your cruise control set or activation just there. And then the beautiful dash that is the Hayabusa. Nice gauges. So on the dash we've got mode C today, and that's power 3, which is the softest. And we're on traction control 10. Like I say, I'm actually running these tyres. It's only done 12 miles, the bike, so I'm having to scrub these in the next few days. You can adjust the traction control, power, quick shifter. It's got an up and down quick shifter on the bike. You've also got things like lift control for the rear, so that when you're braking hard, the rear doesn't lift up. So it's got a six axis IMU, and also that controls your traction control and lean sensitive ABS. But yeah, she's a big old thing, but quite nice. And I do like it in these colours. Somebody mentioned a Duracell battery to me today, and yeah, I can see where they're coming from. Okay, a few questions then from my subscribers. Mark says, does it want to kill you? Well, I've not found out yet. I've been taking it easy, but I'm sure it could do, as it's still very fast. Anand says, how's it like in the twisties? Well, we're going to find out shortly, so I'll give you a final video on this, and also the verdict and my thoughts. We'll be able to answer that a little bit better. Comfort wise, I can tell you the pegs are quite high. I'm 6'2", so my knees are quite bent, and obviously it's quite a sporty position. Although I believe they have raised the handlebars up and back by 12 millimeters from the old version, so it's a little bit more comfy. David asks for weight. Well, we've already told you that. Quick shifter, yes. Tires, these are the Bridgestone S22. These are OE tires made for the bike, so they might not be the same as the S22s that you buy from the tire shop. Personally, I think for the power that this thing's got, S22s, sport bike tires, I think I would put some sport touring tires on this. Probably the Bridgestone T32s would have been better. The bike does have launch control. Not that I'll be using it today or any other day, unless I'm on a drag strip, and that's not going to be the case. So one thing it doesn't have, which is an optional extra, is heated grips. So you have to pay extra for those. But that's about the only thing that I think on this bike that you would pay extra for. It's got everything else. Now, just a bit of history on the bike. First generation Busa. It came out in 1999. Had 173 bhp, and the speedo went up to 220 miles per hour. But as you can see today, they've knocked that back to 180, and also it's limited to about 185, I believe. In 2008, they came up with an update, and that was 194 bhp. I actually rode that one, so it's nice to compare between that and this. And then in 2013, all they did was upgraded the brakes to Brembo and put ABS on the bike.
Now, one thing I can tell you is you don't actually notice what speed you're doing on this bike. I'm just cruising along at 60 just here. Feels like I'm doing 30. I think in the car equivalent, I think you'd be in something like a BMW M5, that classic saloon, family saloon, but an absolute muscle of a car. And the same goes with this bike. It's absolutely blisteringly quick, but you've really got to keep your eyes on the speed to make sure you're not speeding or getting into any trouble. You could really lose your license pretty quick on this thing. But so far so good. It's going to take me a few days to get used to this bike, see what it's actually capable of. Like I say, I'm just trying the tires, just trying to scrub those in just now. We're up to 18 miles on this thing, another 50 or 60 or so just to get these scrubbed in, and then we can start to peel into the bends a bit more. Just from the last few miles, obviously the seating position, I think if you were going on a grand tour on this thing, you would have some wrist ache. The seat is really, really comfortable, but with myself having long legs, the legs are pretty hunched up like on any sport bike, and I normally get achy knees, but that's probably my age. So one thing I noticed just coming through town, through the centre of Milnthorpe just there, is that in first gear, just rolling on and off of the throttle, they seem to have sorted the jerky throttle and it's not a tap anymore, really smooth. So I don't know what they've done with the fueling lowdown, but it's pretty spot on. And I'm actually now in B mode, which is power 2 and traction control 5. So we'll slowly get down to power 1, release all the power as we go through the next few days. So we've just got a bit of dual carriageway to go just now for some more twisties. So I'll cut the video off now and I'll come back and join you shortly. So looking in the rear view mirrors, when we're going over a few bumps and things going down the dual carriageway, I do notice that the mirror's moving and jumping about a little bit. There must be some kind of joint in there with them being foldable, and that's what's making them jump about. I think if they were solid stalks, I don't think you'd have that. It's not off-putting and it's not too bad, as I've seen some on some bikes where they vibrate and then it distorts the picture. The picture is clear as a bell. Just watch the speed camera just here. I did just try the cruise control actually, and that works perfectly. So one thing I didn't mention was the hill hold on this bike. So when you're on a steep incline and you pull up at light, you just pull your brake lever twice and it'll put the hold on so you won't roll backwards. So the actual seat, really comfy on a bit of a distance. I think because you canted forward a little bit on your legs, just takes the weight off a little bit. We'll see over the weekend how my wrists are after a nice long journey. We'll get out and get some miles in and get this thing running if we can. So also the tank as well is really nice and sculpted, so you can get a good grip on the tank to just take that weight off your wrists a little bit. Just trying to think of the competition on this. Now, you had things like the ZZR14 and also the ZH2SX, the touring motorcycle now for Kawasaki, and it's kind of in competition. So I've ridden the supercharged bike a couple of videos ago, actually, with a supercharged engine. And that's 998cc with a supercharger. Obviously, this is 1340 in line 4. Normally aspirated. I much prefer this engine. I do like the way the mirrors just tuck underneath the stalks. Now, it did have the sticker on the tank, and it still does, for E10 fuel. And when I filled up at the petrol station on the way out just now, I didn't put E10 fuel in. I just put the super unleaded in. I'm not a lover of this new E10 fuel. It made my MT10 run like a bag of crap, to be honest. So yeah, so I've got some more miles to do on this bike, and I've got all weekend to do it on and a couple of evenings. So stick around and stay tuned for the follow-up video where I give you my final thoughts and verdict on this bike after putting a few hundred miles on it. So far so good. So I love the price of the bike, 16.5. I was more expecting it up in the 20k range when this first came out, and for every bit of gadgetry you've got on this bike, it pretty much has it all. So yeah, we're just in Hypersports, and I'm going to cut the video there, guys. If you're not a subscriber to the channel, really appreciate you if you could subscribe. It all helps, and give me a thumbs up. I think 80% of the viewers on my videos are not subscribed, so if you're one of those, appreciate it, and thanks, guys. And also the subscribers that are already subscribed, thanks for your support, and we'll see you on another video. Yeah, take care, guys. Cheers.